Welcome back to another video. I know it's been a while since we've done a video like this. Like recording, deck profiles, whatever. But things have been going on with COVID. And we just haven't been able to meet up. My phone stand broke. So we can't record videos as easily. So what I've been doing is doing the ranked on Master Duel. And I got a game in with Steven on Master Duel. But we're trying to get all that fixed up. But for this video, we have a Albaz Cyber Dragon deck. Albaz Cyber. The new structure deck is getting released tomorrow, but the card shops are getting it early. So I already got three of the structure deck before the price spiked. If you're wanting to get Albaz, bunch of good staples, get the structure deck now, tomorrow, as soon as it releases, because when it releases, the price is probably going to go up like crazy. Right now it's at about $15 to $17 for one deck. Get it before it jumps to 50 like Shadal did. So put that aside, this is kind of a budget variant. It's using the Albaz and Cyberstrike structure deck, just three extra deck monsters that I'm proxying two of them at the moment. But let's actually get into the deck profile. So first up, we have our good old Fallen of Albaz. Required for the deck, you can't play an Albaz deck without Albaz. So on summon, you can fusion summon one monster using one monster opponent controls as a fusion material. And we are playing Kaijus, so if like they're playing a water or an earth or any other deck besides light and dark, you can use it and fusion summon. Next up, we have Triple Spriggan's Kit. It's basically an Aluber Jester of Despia, just a little bit worse. If you control an Albaz fusion monster, you can special summon it from your hand. If it's normal or special summoned, you can add one branded spell trap that is banished or in your deck or graveyard to your hand, but then you have to place one card from your hand on the bottom of the deck. So you get to access your branded fusion. I would definitely play Aluber over Kit, but Aluber is not budget right now. I don't have Aluber, and I'm waiting for the reprint. So next up, we have for our last Albaz-ish monster, we have two Tri-Brigade Mercurier. It's basically a hand trap. While you control an Albaz fusion monster, you can discard it to negate a monster effect. And then if it's banished, you can add one Fallen of Albaz or one monster that lists it from your deck to your hand. That's not really going to come up as often, but it can come up every once in a blue moon. Next, we have our Cyber Dragon lineup. We're playing Triple Core. You can't play Cybers without Core, straight up. Add one Cyber Spell Trap from your deck to your hand. Our usual target's going to be the Repair Plant or Cyber Dark Realm. On rare occasion, Emergency too, but just to add your Spell Trap. And if need be, if you don't have the cards that you need, you can banish it to add Special Summon a Cyber Dragon. And then use Power Bond to summon Springed, the Iron Dash Dragon. One Naxxter, one Harris, and one normal Cyber Dragon. Naxxter to get access to your Chimera if you need to send it to Grave with like Fallen of Albaz or Branded Fusion for Fallen of Albaz. One Cyber Dragon. So when you send Harris, if Harris doesn't have another target in Grave, you can target Cyber Dragon. And then for our last of the Cybers, playing one Chimera and two Jinzuku. Jizukiro, sorry. Excuse me for butchering the names. The Kaijus, they're light machines. You can search them off of the repair plant. And Chimera just to access Power Bond. So you can go for the OTK. For generic fusion support, we're playing triple Keeper of Dragon Magic. Summon it, search branded fusion, basically. Or overload fusion if you've already used branded fusion this turn. And then three Effect Veiler. If you want to play Ghost Ogre instead of Effect Veiler, that's fine. I just personally prefer Effect Veiler. I feel negates are more important. Moving on to the spells. We have triple branded fusion, the hands down best fusion card in the game right now. Use this, summon Albion. Albion summon literally any fusion monster that's level 8 or lower. Actually, I don't think it has to be level 8 or lower. Double check. Okay, yeah, it is level 8 or lower. So, Chimera Tech Rampage Dragon. Literally, Cyber Twin Dragon. Other Albaz monsters. And it's a one-card Dragoon. Yay, more of a reason to ban Dragoon and not Verte. And then one branded lost. It's basically a magical meltdown. If you summon a Fallen of Albaz or one mon a Fallen of Albaz fusion monster. You can add one Fallen of Albaz or one monster that lists it from your deck to your hand. No, I'm sorry, any fusion summon you can add Fallen of Albaz. Cyber emergency, just to search your core, your hairs, your Naxxter. Don't want to search hairs, it's the deck material, but, cyber repair plant, to get access to your Kaiju, and to put a Kaiju back into the deck, as the Kaiju is your only access into summoning Brigand, the Glory Dragon, as it takes a level 8 or higher. There is no level 8s in the deck. The only one that's level 8 or higher is the Kaijus. Which is fine. Brigand doesn't come up as much. Or you're just using the monsters in Banish. And then one Cyber Dark Realm and two Power Bond for the Cyber Dark Chimera. And that lineup. Access to Power Bond. So you can OTK with Rampage or... if necessary, you can summon Sprint the Iron Dash Dragon. So you get an additional pop of a column. One Overload Fusion. You can summon Sprint or the Chimera Tech Rampage for OTK. Last spell, Triple Extravagance. Extravagance is amazing. Really amazing. Banish 3 or 6 monsters from your extra deck at random and summon, or draw 2 cards, draw a card for each 3. This has screwed me over like once, but it's not as bad. As long as all 3 of your Albion, at least one of your Albion, one of your Lubellion, and one of your Rampage stays, you're good. Mirror Jade would also be nice to stay. Speaking of, moving on to the extra deck. Mirror Jade, Dragon of the Ice Barrier. Or Ice Barrier. Ice Blade Dragon, oh my god. Every time I hear it, I want to say Ice Barrier, not Ice Blade. So once per turn, you can send a monster from your extra... once per every other turn, you can send a monster from your extra deck to the graveyard to banish a monster on the field. And then if it's sent, leaves the field by an opponent's card, battle, card effect, does not matter, bounce to the hand, extra deck, graveyard, banish. If it leaves the field at all during the end phase, it Raigekis is your opponent's field. Which is very ungodly. Next we have triple Albion, the branded dragon. You need Albion for your combos, and with it getting banished with Extrav, that is not a good thing. So, yeah, triple Albion. Double Lubellion. Lubellion, being one of the newer cards, allows you to discard a card to fusion summon from your field, graveyard, or banished back into the deck. And you just fusion summon a level 8 or lower fusion monster. It's basically just Albion, just instead of hand, it's banish. To Sprint the Iron Dash Dragon. It takes one Fallen of Albaz, and then you can change its column and pop cards in that column. So it's really nice for clearing out your opponent's back row or stuff like that. They have three mons or three cards here. You can move it to that column and pop all three of them. Keep in mind it does pop your own too, so if you have a spell trap in that column, you can screw yourself over. Not that that's really a problem, as I don't play any traps, but or quick play spells. Next we have two Brigand, the Glory Dragon. One level 8 or higher monster. It can't be destroyed by battle, and your opponent cannot target other monsters you control with monster effects. And during the end phase, if it's in the graveyard because it was sent there this turn, you can add one Tri Brigade or Fallen of Albaz or Special Summon. All of them have this effect. Sprind is Spriggan's. Lubellion does not have that effect, surprisingly. Albion is you can set one branded spell or trap from your deck. So that's it for the lineup of Albaz fusions. If you want to cut one Brigand and play a Titanoclad, you can. I don't play the Dogmaticas, and Titanoclad never came up really. So, moving on to the Cyber Dragons. Playing triple Rampage. Unfortunately, I am missing two, so proxies, beautiful. OTK Enabler, that's about it. If you want to cut one of these and play a Mega Fleet, you can. I just never had Mega Fleet come up as often. And then one Chimera Tech Fortress. If it doesn't get banished, you can use your opponent's Kaiju that you gave him, the Jinzuku. But if not, if it gets banished, whatever. If you want to cut a Rampage to play a Fortress, you can. Or cut a Brigand. But yeah, that's about it. Stuff you can play in the side. You can play Artifact Scythe, so when you trigger your Spriggan, it destroys itself. Granted, I don't think that'd be effective, because it has to be destroyed during your opponent's turn. Could play Twin Twisters and pop your own Scythe. But yeah, I will have hopefully a video of this deck in action today. We shall see when the time comes. So, all right, peace out.